Hi, Mark Jamin here, Medical Director for the Haywood County Health Department, and let's talk about this pandemic. I hope you're well and taking seriously the need to isolate if and as soon as you get sick. It gives us the best opportunity to trace, test, and contain, and it's the best thing you can do to protect health and the economy. So I hope you recall episode number 15, The Hammer and the Dance. Well, you know, we had to hammer down hard to get a grip on the virus before we could start the dance. Threading the needle between opening up too much with a risk to health or staying too restrictive with a risk to jobs and livelihoods. The challenge, though, is not to pit health versus the economy. Rather, to preserve both health and the economy, both necessary for our well-being, but each in its proper place. So we hammered down, and to what effect? Well, you know, if you hammer two boards together, but you don't drive the nail fully through, you get a pretty weak joint. Drive it all the way through, though, and what you have is a solid, stable foundation. We have to hammer that nail in as fully as possible to get as solid a foundation of health as is possible before we bring the economy back on board. So have we hammered enough? Many say yes. It's time to get people back to work to save the business. The virus is no big deal here, see? Just 5 cases, and all of those have been contained. And that was true until this week, but not now. This week, the landscape changed. 10 new cases, some with no symptoms, and we can assume more people have been exposed. This time, contact tracing will not effectively hold the lid down, as some did not isolate immediately after developing symptoms. Our situation is changing pretty fast now. The case is doubling faster, and it's too early to tell how many more of those exposed are actually infected, since symptoms may not show for up to 2 weeks. We'll know more by that time. To further muddy the waters, we are surrounded by 4 states who are opening up. It will take 2 to 3 weeks before we can draw any conclusions from their experience, but you can count on that affecting us here. I think it's safe to say the heat has been turned up. The pot is starting to boil a bit more. So we must ask ourselves, is this really the time to turn up the burner even more by opening up? Have we hammered enough to withstand this wave of infection? If we continue to double cases at this pace, over the next 2 weeks, we will be a hotspot. Now you may be thinking, hold on, it's only 10 new cases. But doubling every 3 days, those 10 become 300 by mid-May in just over 2 weeks. And we can't afford that, especially if we start seeing people on ventilators. But that's where we may very well be headed. It's here, folks. So let's be honest. Nobody knows the optimal time to reopen the economy. Everyone is experimenting, and we now have a glimpse of how the dance will go. Lots of uncertainty, steps forward, steps back. Be prepared to tuck in, because it will be a long haul no matter what we choose to do. There is no returning fully to normal anytime soon, if ever. But rather than focus on all the what-ifs, let's focus on what you can do today to preserve health and the economy. Do your part, residents and visitors alike. Double down on the public health measures. Keep your distance and avoid gatherings. Wear a mask in public areas. Stay home if you can. Wash hands, especially before touching your face, and expect others to do the same. We need more of this right now, not less. Learn from this past week. If we can track and trace contacts effectively, we can contain an outbreak. If not, we're destined for more suffering, not less. And here is the key. If you get sick, isolate as soon as you don't feel well, just like those first 5 cases did, and contact your doctor or the health department to get tested. It gives us the best opportunity to do our job well. So remember, protect yourself, and because you might be an asymptomatic carrier, protect others from you. Be well, stay emotionally connected, and physically distant.